तत्रहामर्षितो भीमः तस्य श्रेयान्वधः स्मृतः नाभर्तूर्नात्मानश्चार्ते योहान् सुप्तान् शिशून् वृथा. ट्रांसलेशन: भीमा हाउएवर डिसअग्रीड विद देम एंड रेकमेंडेड किलिंग दिस कल्प्रिट हू इन एंग्री मूड हैड मर्डर्ड स्लीपिंग चिल्ड्रन फॉर नो पर्पस एंड फॉर नीदर हिज नॉर हिज मास्टर्स इंटरेस्ट. टेक्स्ट 52. निशम्य भीम गदितं द्रौपद्याश्च चतुर्भुजः आलोक्य वदनं सख्युः इदं आहाह सन्निव. ट्रांसलेशन एंड पार्ट बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद. चतुर्भुज द फोर आर्म्ड वन और द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड आफ्टर हियरिंग द वर्ड्स ऑफ भीमा द्रौपदी एंड अदर्स सॉ द फेस ऑफ हिज डियर फ्रेंड अर्जुन एंड ही बिगैन टू स्पीक एज इफ smiling. Purport: Lord Shri Krishna had two arms, and why he is designated as four-armed is explained by Sridhara Swami. Both Bhima and Draupadi held opposite views about killing Ashwatthama. Bhima wanted him to be immediately killed, whereas Draupadi wanted to save him. We can imagine Bhima ready to kill while Draupadi is obstructing him. And in order to prevent both of them, the Lord discovered another two arms. Originally, the primeval Lord Shri Krishna displays only two arms, but in his Narayana feature, he exhibits four. In his Narayana feature, he resides with his devotees in the Vaikuntha planets, while in his original Shri Krishna feature, he resides in the Krishna Loka planet, far, far above the Vaikuntha planets in the spiritual sky. Therefore, if Shri Krishna is called Chaturbhujaha, there is no contradiction. If need be, he can display hundreds of arms, as he exhibited in his Vishwarupa shown to Arjuna. Therefore, one who can display hundreds and thousands of arms can also manifest four whenever needed. When Arjuna was perplexed about what to do with Ashwatthama, Lord Shri Krishna, as the very dear friend of Arjuna, voluntarily took up the matter just to make a solution. And he was smiling also. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta Purport. ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने. नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे विशेषा शून्यवादे पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे. हरे कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे हरे, हरे रामा हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे. सो वे डिस्कसिंग वर्सेस फ्रॉम चैप्टर The son of Drona punished. So the background of the today's verse is that Drona, the son of Ashwatthama, the son of Dronacharya, had beheaded, murdered ruthlessly the five children of Draupadi, that too when they were sleeping. So Draupadi was very, very sad and upset that she has lost all her five children. And she was crying very sadly with great sadness in her heart. Arjuna made a vow that I will catch the murderer, Ashwatthama. I'll bring him, I'll give him befitting punishment. So Arjuna and Krishna goes, they catch Ashwatthama. Now Ashwatthama is brought before Draupadi. His hands and legs are tied. And Draupadi is very sorry to see the scene. She says, "Oh no, this is not the way we treat the son of our guru, Dronacharya. Please release him." Then he is released. Then, now everyone is very angry that Ashwatthama has killed the 5 sons of Pandavas. That too when they were sleeping, they didn't have an opportunity to defend themselves. How could this Ashwatthama do such a heinous activity? So in such a situation, now actually the mother who has lost the 5 children is the one who is most affected. So everyone is looking at Draupadi, what she wants to do with Ashwatthama. Surprisingly, mother who has lost all her 5 children is suggesting that we may not kill Ashwatthama. And immediately even Yudhishthira Maharaj agreed, and Nakulan Sahadeva, Nakulaha Sahadevascha Yuyudhano Dhananjayaha. Arjuna, Dhananjaya, Nakula, Sahadeva, everyone agreed. Yes, yes, what Yudhishthira Maharaj and Draupadi, they are saying is correct. We may not kill this Ashwatthama. But Bhima was very angry. He was not at all in disagreement with this. He said, "No, this man, Ashwatthama, he has murdered our 5 sons in a heinous manner. We must not spare him. We must kill him." So he had an opposite view. So now Krishna, who was watching this scene, now he saw there are 2 different views. One view that Draupadi holds, that let's not kill, and she is supported by Yudhishthira Maharaj, Arjuna, Nakula, Sahadeva, Satyaki and few others. And Bhima on the other side, he says, "No way, we cannot spare such a sinful man. Let's kill him." So at that point of time, Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Devaki Putraha, he did something very nice. It is said, Chaturbhujaha, Krishna, the one who has got 2 arms, exhibited the form of Chaturbhuja, the 4-handed form. Krishna was there with 2 hands. Now he exhibited the 4 hands, the different form, a Narayana form. Now Srila Prabhupada is quoting from Sridhara Swami, why is Krishna exhibiting different form? And Prabhupada clarifies, actually Bhima had one view, Draupadi had another view. So in order to prevent them, Krishna wanted 2 more hands. So he discovered 2 more arms to stop them from their different viewpoints. So it's a very interesting point that, you know, here it is brought out. The form of the Lord. It's a very deep subject matter, the form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we know in the main temple all we see the deity has got 2 hands, and we have seen many, many pictures of Lord Krishna having 2 hands. And we also have seen Narayana, none other than Krishna, also having 4 hands. So Krishna having all those different forms, a rupa, is actually for a very, very special reason. It is said, the acharyas explain the science behind Krishna exhibiting different forms to different devotees. Actually, it is said, Krishna is a person. As a person, he is individual. So he individually reciprocates with his devotees. His reciprocation with his devotees is very individual. And his form, the form of Lord Krishna, is also very, very individual to the individual devotee, which is suitable. Krishna exhibits the form which is suitable for the devotees to enjoy their particular relationship with Krishna. We all know that devotees primarily enjoy the 5 kinds of relationship with Krishna. The five bhakti rasas. Shanta rasa, dasya rasa, sakhya rasa, vatsalya rasa and madhurya rasa. There are devotees, for example, Arjuna, he is having relationship with Krishna in the mood of sakhya rasa, friendly relationship. Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj, Devaki, Vasudeva, they have vatsalya rasa, parental relationship. Srimati Radharani, Lalita, Vishakha and other gopis, they have madhurya rasa relationship. Now, the acharyas explain how Krishna exhibits different forms to different devotees according to their relationship in which they enjoy a different rasa, mellow, bhakti mellow. That rasa which is required can be evoked. A particular rasa, let's say for example, vatsalya rasa that Mother Yashoda enjoys with Krishna can be evoked. The emotions associated with vatsalya rasa can be evoked in the heart of the devotee with a particular form. So when Krishna deals with that particular devotee, he exhibits a form which is suitable to evoke those particular rasa in the heart of the devotees. So this is very, very important to make a note. For example, Mother Yashoda, she loves Krishna as a baby child. Acharyas explain how the child form is very much suitable for the vatsalya rasa. And Krishna reciprocates with the devotees like Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj, Devaki, Vasudeva and elderly Gopa and Gopas of Vrindavana with his Bala Rupa, with the form of a child. Actually, Krishna is the Vishaya of the love. We have loving relationship with Krishna. And Krishna is the Vishaya of the love. Vishaya means object. He is the object of our love. And devotee's heart is the ashraya of that love. Ashraya means shelter. So Krishna takes the shelter in the heart of his devotees in a particular form. So what is the form that exists in the Yashoda's heart? The form is a Bala Rupa, the child form, which exists in the heart of Mother Yashoda. And Mother Yashoda experiences the highest vatsalya rasa when she sees Krishna in his baby form or child form, Bala Rupa. We all know when the child is very small, the baby is just taken birth, is completely dependent on mother or father, mostly mother. So the vatsalya rasa is fully experienced when the child is completely dependent on only on mother or father and mother. The child at that stage, it doesn't even have friends. All the rasa, all the relationship is only for father and mother, or especially mother. So the mother experiences the complete vatsalya rasa when the child is very small, infant. The child cannot eat independent of mother. The child cannot go from one place to another place without mother's help. If mother is not there, child starts crying. Mother is the whole universe for the child. So this kind of a experience that my child is completely dependent on me, I am the sarvasva, or I am everything for my child, is actually possible in the vatsalya rasa. So Mother Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj and elderly gopas and gopis of Vrindavana, they experience when Krishna exhibits his Kaumara Rupa, his child baby form is called Kaumara Rupa. Kaumara Rupa means it is 1 to 5 or 0 to 5. When the baby is up to 5 years, it is called Kaumara. In such a stage, baby is dependent on mother. It is not independent, it is completely dependent. The relationship between mother Yashoda and baby Krishna is very intense. Very, very intense. Krishna doesn't have any friends at that time. He only has mother Yashoda and nobody else. So this is the form mother Yashoda, you know, enjoys. And Krishna, being individual person, he reciprocates with mother Yashoda in Vatsalya Rasa in the Bala Rupa. This we see in the very famous verse of Damodarashtaka. In the Damodarashtaka, Vyasadeva records a prayer by Satyavrata Muni. He says, how beautiful this form of Bala Rupa. He says, Varam Deva Moksham Na Moksha Vadhimva Nachanyam Vrineham Vareshadapiha Idamte Vapurnatha Gopala Balam. Bala Gopala Sadame Manasyavirastam Kim Anyai. I don't want any other form. One form I want to continuously behold, and for this I don't even care. Moksha, liberation. This, the baby form of Lord Krishna, Bala Rupa or Bala Gopala, Idamte Vapurnata Gopala Balam. He says it is so attractive. It is so nice to relish for devotees. He says, in front of this form of Lord Krishna called Gopala Bala, moksha becomes insignificant. So I don't want even liberation. I want to continuously behold the form that Krishna exhibit as a Gopala Balam. And I don't want Kim Anyai. What is the use of all other benediction in front of this benediction of having the darshan of Lord Krishna in this form? So this is how Mother Yashoda, Nanda Maharaj and others enjoy, and Krishna reciprocates with them with this particular form called Kaumara Rupa. Now, after Kaumara Rupa, after 5 years, as a child starts growing, this child will have so many friends. Every father, mother knows this. The child is so busy with friends and playing with the friends. You know, sometimes literally mother has to go and drag the child from the playground. Come home. Have you forgotten the home? You're always with friends. So that is the age between 5 to 10 called Pauganda Rupa that Krishna exhibits. He exhibits the form which is very much suitable for friendly relationship. All his friends, Sudam, Madhumangal and many of others, they'll all enjoy with Krishna in the form that Krishna exhibits between 5 to 10 years called Pauganda Rupa. You see, generally friends don't like a small kids, you know, holding on to the mother, always saying, mummy, mummy, you know, my mother, like this. The friends don't know, what is this always, mummy? A doodh piya, you know, like this, they say, it's a milk drinking baby it is. We don't want you in our group. They like a friend who is very adventurous. They like somebody who is very, very mischievous and who is ready to go and, you know, take any adventure and do anything that friends want. So they want somebody who is like that. They don't want somebody who is completely dependent, who is always with mother, who is always saying, oh, my mummy is important for me. No. They want a friend who is very adventurous, who is very strong. So we see in Little Krishna videos and Srimad Bhagavatam and Krishna books, Srila Prabhupada explains how Krishna is so adventurous. Every day they come up with new adventure. Sometimes they walk into the caves, sometimes they walk into the big mouth of a Aghasura, And you know, the friends say, "Hey, what is this cave? Looks very dangerous." Other say, "Hey, come on, Krishna is there, he will protect us." So they all see Krishna not as a milk drinking baby. They see Krishna as a very adventurous boy. So that kind of the form that Krishna exhibits with his friends, that's called a form which is suitable to evoke the Sakya Rasa in the heart of his devotees. There are devotees who want to enjoy with Krishna in that way. So Krishna reciprocates with them the form which is suitable, which can evoke the feelings, the emotions of a friend, not as a father and mother. So Mother Yashoda decorates Krishna at home with jewels and, you know, all that, hair she will tie here, and she decorates like a child. Like you might have seen how the mother decorates a small baby. She will tie one knot, the hair knot, and put some flower and, you know, put some bindi and all that. And she decorates because she is enjoying Vatsalya Rasa with Krishna in the Bala Rupa. And the moment Krishna comes out, now he has to go with his friends with so many thousands and lakhs of calves. And all the friends look at Krishna and they say, "What is this? What is this? Our friend has come in this dress." They immediately remove all that. This is not looking good for you. And they, it is said in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, the 23rd chapter, where the Dvijapatnis, the wives of Brahmanas, how they saw Krishna. So there it is mentioned how Krishna was decorated by his friends. Now friends decorate him. At home, Mother Yashoda decorates, and she enjoys Krishna's Balarupa. And the moment Krishna comes out, now Krishna is, now he is decorated now by his friends. Now friends, they don't like Krishna being decorated like a baby. They want to be like an adventurous boy. So they take out all the jewels. They remove all that what Mother Yashoda has put. They take some minerals from the earth, you know, some colors and all that. They paint on his face. They put one, you know, flower garland called Vanamali, the garland which they make out of flowers in the forest. So they take that, they garland Krishna, and they change his hairstyle, and now he looks like an adventurous friend. Now they say, "Come on, let's go." So now they go. And Krishna allows them to do that. Krishna allows Mother Yashoda to enjoy a particular form which is suitable for her Vatsalya Rasa, and Krishna allows his friends to enjoy the Sakya Rasa form between 5 to 10 years. You see? And now all the friends, sometimes you're seen in the friendship with the boy stuff, "Hey, whose biceps is more? Oh, yours, Krishna, mine." And they have competitions, and sometimes they say, who will run faster, sometimes who will carry whom. All that kind of adventurous competitions are held. Sometimes Krishna is defeated, he has to carry Madhumangala on his back. You know, all that happens with friends in a particular form that Krishna exhibits, which is called Pauganda form or Pauganda Rupa. And now Krishna is exhibiting Bala Rupa to his parents and other elderly people of Vrindavan. He is exhibiting Pauganda Rupa, the form which is suitable for his friends, to his Vrindavan friends. Now what about gopis? The young gopis who have Madhurya Rasa relationship with Krishna, the conjugal relationship. They don't like small baby. You cannot have a Madhurya Rasa relationship with a small baby drinking milk. You can't have a conjugal relationship with somebody who is playing with friends. They want a Kaishora Rupa. Kaishora Rupa means a teenager. He's not a small baby. He's not playing with friends. He's grown up young boy. And Krishna exhibits his Kaishora Rupa to his beloved young gopis of Vrindavan, and that form is between 11 to 15 or 16. That is called Kaishora Rupa, Kishora. Kishora or Kishori. There is one ISKCON temple which the deities are named after Shri Shri Kishora and Kishori. Like we say Radha and Krishna, they say Kishora Kishori temple. That means a young girl and a young boy. So Krishna exhibits a form which is suitable to evoke the Madhurya Rasa feelings in the heart of young gopis. So in, again in Srimad Bhagavatam, Krishna book that Prabhupada has given us, we read how the gopis were mad after the Krishna's Kishora form. Srila Prabhupada quotes this many times. He says, oh, one gopi is telling to another gopi, my dear gopi, please don't go near Yamuna river. One gopi is warning another young gopi, please don't go to that Yamuna river. This gopi is asking, why? Why are you giving me such a warning? She says, if at all you are interested in your family life, please listen to me very carefully. Don't go near that Yamuna river. Even if you happen to go, please immediately close your ears. Don't dare to even, you know, hear 1 minute. Because there will be some enchanting flute sound you will hear. If at all you have got any plans to enjoy with your family members, please close your ears immediately. Don't go. Even if you happen to go, don't hear this flute music. Let somebody said, okay, fine, we went there, we heard that, next what? What if you have done that? He says, chalo, even if you have gone there, even if you somehow by mistake you heard that sound, please don't see that face of that boy called Govinda. If you see, you are finished. Then you have to forget everything. Over. Because what is the speciality of that form of Govinda? He's so young and attractive. Anybody sees that form of a Govinda who is in the form of a Kishora, they will simply forget all the relationship they have in this material world, all the responsibilities they have to execute, all that they forget. They become mad after that form. So the gopi is warning, don't see that form. So that is a kind of a form which is maddening the young gopis. That is exhibited by same Krishna called Kishora Rupa to the young gopis. So we have to understand how Krishna's form or the Rupa, which here we are seeing because he exhibited the Chaturbhuja form to all those who assembled there. So we are discussing how Krishna's form is so dynamic according to the relationship, according to what is required for a devotee to enjoy and relish, he reveals that form. Krishna's form is very dynamic. It is not a static. Static means one kind of form, for everyone it is same. No, it is not same. Krishna reveals suitable form to his devotees for their particular relationship that they have got. Now, there are some instances where Krishna exhibits all the suitable forms simultaneously, where all the devotees enjoy his form according to their relationship. There are certain instances. Some instances that, you know, Bilva Mangal Thakur mentions in Govinda Damodara Madhaveti, the very famous song. He says that after Krishna tending the cows in the forest, now he has to return back in the evening. It is evening, so he wants to return back to Vrindavan from the forest of Vrindavan. So that time Krishna first plays the flute. And now the moment he starts playing the flute, all the cows are expected to come. But now, the no cows and calves are coming, even after hearing Krishna's enchanting flute. And Krishna knows why they are not coming. And Krishna immediately starts calling their names. Ravali, Dhavali, please come, it's late. And these calves, who are actually enchanted by Krishna's beautiful flute song, now they were waiting that Krishna should call us by our own name. The moment Krishna calls by every individual name of the calves, they just start jumping out of jubilation. That's like a perfection of their life. Krishna calling my name. let's run. And they all come and surround Krishna. And now Krishna with all his friends, he says, come on, let's go now. Let's go towards Vrindavan home. So now they're all moving. So while they're moving, Krishna, he positions himself at the last. And there are all the cows and calves and his friends, everybody is in the front. So now this Bilva Mangal Thakur in the Govind Damodar Stotra, he very nicely mentions, he says, oh Krishna, you are so careful. You are a Gopal. You know, we know this famous name of a Gopal. Gopala. Pala means the one who maintains, the one who takes care. Now Krishna, because he takes care of the cows and calves, is called Gopal. He says, oh my dear Lord, you as Gopal, you are so careful that you are coming at the end, last, making sure that not even single calf goes here and there. Everyone is protected and everyone is in the group. You see? Actually, there is one similar story in Bible where the God, I mean, in our understanding, we call cowherd boy. So the Lord Jesus tells a story of a shepherd. He says, God as a shepherd. So he says, once the God, the shepherd, he was coming back. It was in the evening. As a shepherd, he had a lot of sheep and 100 sheep. And the shepherd notices the one sheep is missing in the herd. And he immediately becomes worried about that sheep. He says, where is that sheep? I have to go and search. You see, from the practical business point of view, it's already in the evening. And if you go to search that one sheep which is missing, you may lose the 99 sheep which are there. And it is already evening and these sheep may wander away and they may go away. It is a little difficult. You may lose some sheep. But actually when it comes to God, he never does this kind of a practical business calculation. The God's love for his devotees is not calculative love. It is love out of love. So that one sheep missing in his group becomes so intolerant for the shepherd, he goes and he searches that missing sheep and he lovingly he carries that sheep back and he takes all the 100 sheep and he goes. So Lord Krishna or the Lord's love is never based on some practical business calculation. Krishna doesn't say, oh, I will protect this devotee because he's useful. He does a lot of service. So I will protect this devotee. If I protect him, there is a lot of use. You know, it's very good for my, maybe my mission, my temple. So I will give protection to this. That devotee is not doing so much service. He's almost like useless. So I will not protect him. This is not the way that Krishna protects his devotees. Krishna protects every devotee with utmost love. He never does such calculation. He is useful, he is not useful. Everyone is so important for Krishna. He can never tolerate somebody being neglected. That is the kind of love God has for all of us. So, anyway, Krishna, and we know, of course, from Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur's pastime, how when Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur visited one place where the new Gaudiya Matha temple was supposed to be inaugurated, and Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur noticed one particular, his disciple, was missing. And immediately Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur asked, where is that such and such devotee? He is not to be seen. Then they said, oh, you know, my dear Guru Maharaj, he was into some kind of problem and we scolded him, we chased him out of the temple. He is no more in the temple. Then Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur started crying. He said, how can you do this? How could you do this with my disciple? With great struggle that Jiva has come to Krishna. And he has taken up Krishna in his life. And for one mistake, you've sent him out of the temple. As long as he chants holy name and he takes the Vaishnava association, for sure he's going to be purified. And he is not there. I don't want to attend this temple inauguration if that devotee is not there. And the disciples of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur they were just puzzled. Oh my God. What is this? And they went out and they searched everywhere and they brought that disciple. They went and told him, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur is saying, without you we cannot inaugurate this temple. Please come. And that devotee started crying. He said, oh my God, why am I missing such a spiritual master, such a Krishna conscious environment? Why, even in spite of you people scolding me, I should have stayed back. Now I realize what is the love of my spiritual master, what is the love of Krishna for his devotees. So he came back and then the temple was inaugurated. So like this, Krishna's love, his devotees' love is not based on some practical business estimation. One Srila Prabhupada was attending Guru Puja in Mayapur and devotees were coming in the queue to offer flowers to Srila Prabhupada. And one devotee was coming and he was limping. He was not able to walk properly. And Srila Prabhupada, in the midst of that Guru Puja, he said, what happened to you? Why are you limping? The devotee said, Prabhupada, I was doing some service and I got some kind of a wound and because of which I'm not. Did you go to doctor? The Prabhupada asked, he said, no, I told my temple authority and they were quite busy. I think, I couldn't go. Maybe I think I may go today. Prabhupada said, no, don't delay. And immediately Prabhupada took out the money from his own pocket and gave to his disciple. He said, today itself you should go to doctor. Prabhupada never thought, I have got 10,000 disciples. Here is one disciple who has got some problem. Somebody will take care of him. I have had so many, authorities, they will look after him. I don't have to worry. My Guru Puja is going on, I have to focus on that. No! The Acharya's love, Krishna's love is so unconditional that they never calculate like this and love. You see? This is the kind of love that Krishna and his devotees, Acharyas like Srila Prabhupada, exhibit for his devotees and his disciples. So now when Krishna is coming with all the cows, and that is a time when all the devotees will relish his beautiful form. So now the Bilva Mangal Thakur says, my dear Lord, you are Gopal, you are protecting all the cows. You are careful that you are protecting all the cows and calves. Similarly, my dear Lord, you are my Gopal also. Because in Sanskrit, the go also refers to five senses. That's why we say Goswami, the one who has conquered the urges of the senses, or one who has brought the senses under his control. Or we say Godasa, the materialistic person is called Godasa. Go also refers to senses. He says, my dear Lord, you are not just Gopal in Vrindavan, you are also my Gopal. You are the maintainer of my five senses. You are so careful, you are not allowing any cows to go here and there. But how can you allow all my five senses wandering here and there? You have to protect my five senses. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur also mentions in very famous Gopinath song, Tumi Rishikena, oh my dear Lord, you are the Rishikesha, the master of the five senses. So you are the Gopal, you are the Pala, you are the maintainer of my five senses. So how can you allow my five senses to go out of the control? Please bring them under your control and you direct my five senses to do your devotional service. My dear Lord, you are my Gopal. So like this, Bilva Mangal Thakur very beautifully describes in Govinda Damodara Madhaveti song. And he says, when they are coming, and now the form, now in the forest, when Krishna is in the forest, now the Krishna's friends, they have enjoyed the form. Right? Krishna is smeared with the dust, playing with the friends and all that. So now the daytime, the sakya, the friendship, the suitable, the form of Lord Krishna which is suitable for his friends was enjoyed by his friends. In the morning and in the evening, the mother Yashoda, Vasudeva, Devaki or Nanda Maharaj are elderly gopas and gopis. They enjoy the vatsalya, rasa, rupa of Lord Krishna in the morning and evening. And then in the night, the young gopis enjoy the Kaishora Rupa of Lord Krishna. So, but all this is simultaneously exhibited when Krishna comes back from the forest to this. So now all the friends, Balram and, they're all in the front and Krishna is coming at the back. And that is the time, now all the calves, they're actually, they're in a very, very difficult state of mind. They are in a calf, they are very young. They are neither so young that they are fully dependent on the mother calf's milk, nor fully grown up that they can eat only grass. They also take the mother's milk, they also need grass. So now they have tasted the grass in the forest, now they go home, they know that if I reach Vrindavan home, we will get mother's milk. But they were also the calves. You know, it is mentioned in the scripture, not just human beings enjoy the beauty of Lord Krishna. Every living entity in this creation enjoys the beauty of Lord Krishna, the form of Lord Krishna. So the calves, they are feeling so bad. If we reach home, we will not be able to see Krishna's form. So he says, the two legs of the calves are moving towards Vrindavan, to their home, and the two legs, the backside, they are not moving. So they are like in a suspended state. They are not moving because they are going to miss drinking the nectar of Krishna's form. So now they see back. Now Krishna smilingly assures them, don't worry, move. I'm there. Then all the calves happily move towards Vrindavan. So now, when Krishna is not at home, all the mother Yashoda, Gopas and Gopis, elderly Gopas, Nanda Maharaj, they're all missing Krishna. The rasa, the Vatsalya rasa, which they were enjoying, seeing the Bala Rupa of Krishna, now they are missing whole day. Viraha Athura. Athura means they are so eager to again have the darshan. It is so intolerable. They just can't wait till Krishna reaches home. So what do? They all come and stand outskirts of Vrindavan village to behold Krishna coming from Vrindavan forest. When Krishna has gone forest, they'll see Vrindavan forest because Vrindavan forest reminds them of Krishna. And now they stand and they watch, they wait Krishna coming out from the Vrindavan forest. And the first indication is that there's a huge dust raising and becoming a big cloud of dust. That is an indication all the calves are walking and Krishna is coming. And now all the elderly Gopas and Gopis, including Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj, they're waiting to have darshan. And now all the young Gopis, even they are missing Krishna. They also want to have Krishna's Kishora form. So they cannot come out like Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj and stand, you know, in Vedic culture you can stand and watch form of Lord Krishna. So they somehow figure out some work and they go on top of the terrace and they'll be waiting there Krishna to enter Vrindavan. So like this, the friends who enjoyed the form of Krishna in the forest, the parents of Krishna who were missing Krishna's Vatsalya form, they were again waiting to enjoy Krishna's form. And the young gopis who are missing Krishna's Kishora form, they are also waiting. So when Krishna returns back from the forest, everyone feels happy and relish seeing the form. So Krishna reciprocates with all the devotees like this with different forms. There are two more instances where Krishna simultaneously exhibited all the forms to all his devotees. And that one very famous instance is Govardhan pastime. When Krishna lifted Govardhan, Mother Yashoda, who is in Vatsalya Rasa, who wants to see as a small baby. The baby is, you know, incapable. You can't expect a baby to lift on such a big hill like that. And Yashoda, you know, the form that Krishna is showing there is creating anxiety in the heart of Yashoda. When a small baby is doing some very, very such a adventurous thing, the mother will be in anxiety. Oh my God, what is that my baby is doing? My baby is so, you know, incapable. If I feed, he takes the food. If I don't take care, he cannot be. Such a, my Krishna, my such a, you know, incapable young baby Krishna, he is lifting Govardhan hill. So Mother Yashoda feels anxiety when she sees Krishna lifting Govardhan hill. And now the friends of Lord Krishna, they don't feel anxiety seeing Krishna. They feel very pride. Yes, our friend is lifting Govardhan. You see, when some of your friends achieve something very adventurous and we are very proud of that, you say, yes, my friend, he did that. They are not experiencing any anxiety, concern like Mother Yashoda. They are enjoying. Yes, yes, he is our friend. Look at his biceps. See how strong he is. See how he is holding. And they are enjoying Krishna in that form. You see, simultaneously, Mother Yashoda is also enjoying seeing Krishna and having anxiety. Oh my God, what is this? And Krishna is having, at the same time, exhibiting the form which is suitable to his friends also. There, yes. And now in the same, you know, below Govardhan, there are young gopis. They are also seeing Krishna and they are feeling so attracted because Krishna is like a hero. You know, in the movies we see when hero performs a heroic action and a heroine gets attracted to such a hero. He must perform something very extraordinary activity. And Krishna here, without a doubt, is demonstrating that he is the hero of Vrindavan. And all the young gopis, and they are just feeling conjugal attraction to Krishna and seeing him lifting Govardhana hill. So like this, Krishna, he exhibited all the forms which were suitable to all his devotees to enjoy their relationship. Either it is Vatsalya Rasa relationship or Sakya Rasa relationship or Madhurya Rasa relationship to his devotees in Govardhana pastime. It is again mentioned by Acharyas, actually when Krishna lifted Govardhan hill, above the Govardhan hill, there was a dark bluish cloud. You know, Samvartaka cloud, dark bluish cloud. So big, heavily raining, creating so much of problems, so much of rain, dark bluish cloud above the Govardhan hill. And the Acharyas say, under the Govardhan hill also one cloud was there. And that cloud was also dark bluish cloud. And that dark bluish cloud called Krishna was also pouring the rain. And that rain was the rain of a bhakti rasa to all his devotees. So there were two clouds. Above Govardhana hill, a dark bluish cloud which was pouring a lot of water. And under Govardhana hill, one more bluish, black bluish cloud called Krishna, Nila Megha Shyama, Krishna, who was also showering the rain of Vatsalya, Sakya, Madhurya to his devotees. So like this, Krishna gives that enjoyment to his devotees and he reciprocates, and seeing the devotees enjoying, he also enjoys. So this is the speciality of Krishna's form. And also when Krishna entered Mathura, you can read in Krishna book, Srila Prabhupada entered, how different people saw Krishna differently. Kamsa saw Krishna in a form of death. Kamsa, when Krishna entered the arena of that, where wrestling is supposed to take place, Kamsa saw Krishna as his death. He didn't see Sakya, Madhurya, Vatsalya. By seeing Krishna, he didn't feel some affection. Oh, small baby, so nice. No, he got frightened. He saw, oh my God, my death is approaching me. Yogis saw Krishna as Paramatma. All the elderly gopas and gopis saw Krishna as a small baby. And they became concerned. Oh, this baby is entering. How will he fight? We should give protection to my baby. But all the young boys, they were all very, our friend will win. You see, I will bet our Krishna, our friend, hero, he will win. And all the young gopis or young girls of Mathura, they were all feeling attracted to Krishna, seeing the form. Like this, everyone saw Krishna differently. And Krishna simultaneously exhibited that form. You see, in our case, what happens when you grow, when you become, 30 years old, 40 years old, our mother may not relish the childhood form that she used to relish. We are incapable of reciprocating with our mother with the form which we relished Vatsalya Rasa. Now you cannot be with your friends and doing all those adventures which we did in our childhood. So Sakya Rasa we cannot reciprocate. You see, we are limited in our form. But Krishna, being unlimited, his unlimited Lord, simultaneously can exhibit unlimited forms and give satisfaction to all his devotees. So that is the form of Lord Krishna. Now, somebody may say, okay, Krishna and his devotees enjoyed that. What about us? We are not so advanced. We don't have relationship with Krishna like that. Which is the form that we have to enjoy? Which is the form that which is available for us? So, Sri Ramanujacharya gives one good example. He says there are different forms, different rupas of Lord Krishna. He says there is something called Pararupa. Pararupa means spiritual form of the Lord, which is in the spiritual world. And that form, he compares, you know, Ramanujacharya from Sri Vaishnava Sampradaya. He says that form is like a Narayana, the Garbhodaka ocean. It's like a, you know, it's like a water in the ocean. If you feel thirsty, you need water to quench your thirst. But where is the water? We all know water is there in the ocean. But when I am thirsty right now, can I go and take the water from the ocean? It is not possible. Like that, we know that Krishna, who is there in the Vaikuntha, with very nice form, now I don't have access to such a form to enjoy. Next, there is a form of Lord Krishna called Vyuha Rupa. Vyuha Rupa means Chatur Vyuha Rupa. Sankarshana Pradyumna Aniruddha Vasudeva. So he, you know, we know that it is like that. The Krishna exists with beautiful forms as a Vyuha Rupa. Even that is not accessible to ordinary people like us. Because that is compared just like a cloud in the sky. We are thirsty and I can see the cloud. I know that there is a lot of water in the cloud. But I cannot access the water in the cloud. That is not possible for me. It is not accessible. And the next, the form that the Acharya say, Antaryami form. The form which exists within us as a Paramatma. Krishna is there. Very beautiful Lord. He is there. Yogis meditate upon him. So, but that is like a water. It's an underground water. It's there, but it is deep within the earth. Now, when somebody is thirsty, can they start digging the borewell and that time they want to quench their thirst? It is not possible. And then there is something called Vibhava Rupa or Vibhava form of the Lord. And that form of the Lord is compared to incarnations. Rama, Parashurama, you know, all those incarnations, Narasimha, Vamana. Very beautiful Lord comes, takes incarnation, he comes. But they are compared to rains. You know, we all know that when it rains, there is a lot of water. But that is only during rainy season. Let's say in summer, in winter season, you may not have rain, you may not get that water to drink. Like that, the incarnations come. Beautiful Rupa, the form is available for his devotees. But it was only during that time. Now, we may not get that. So what is the form of the Lord which is available for us? The Acharya say, the form which is available for us is called Archa form. Archa Vigraha Rupa. The form of a deity. The deity incarnation of the Lord. This is the beauty of Lord Krishna, Archa form, which is available for us. And all the scriptures, especially Agama Shastra, Narada Pancharatra, so many Acharyas have given so much of, you know, explanation, how we can relish the deities, how we can enjoy by decorating, by seeing the form, which is so satisfying to the living entities. That is how the Acharyas take the hard work of establishing temple, establishing the deities everywhere, all around the world, so that form we see and we get attracted to Krishna the way other devotees got attracted to Krishna. Now, in the beginning, somebody may say, oh, when I come to a temple, I see Krishna, but I may not relish the deity, the form of the deity. Actually, in the beginning, the form of Lord Krishna is not a relishable activity for us. It is some kind of a relief. We are so agitated by our worldly desires, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, matsarya. You know, we can't relish the Krishna's form at the present moment. We can only get relief from our material contamination by having the form. But the relief leads to relish someday. So if you continue to come and have the darshan of the Lord in his Archa Vigraha, like you all have come to temple, have darshan, and dance in front of him, sing in front of him, offer foodstuff him, and behold, dress him, and the festival days, the Lord is decorated in a very different, nice way, and when we come and behold and enjoy that beauty, That beauty will take us to relishing Krishna's form and purifying our heart, and one day we will see Krishna face to face, as you know, the devotees that we discussed now. So that is possible only when we first of all take the available blessings of Archavigraha. And that Archavigraha also we can appreciate only when we follow sadhana bhakti. When we chant Hare Krishna mantra, immediately our senses get purified. Only with that purified senses, we can have the darshan. Of course, anybody can have darshan. It is said even the animal sees the form of a Archavigraha gets purified. But you can relish, you can, you know, feel more if you do sadhana and have the darshan of the Lord. So like you all have experienced, general public having darshan, the devotees having darshan, there is a lot of difference. Because the devotees perform sadhana. Every day they chant Hare Krishna mantra, holy name, hear Srimad Bhagavatam. It is said, Shrutekshita. In Srimad Bhagavatam it is said, Shrutekshita. Ikshita means seeing. The seeing, not just seeing, Shrutekshita. Seeing through the hearing. So when you hear Srimad Bhagavatam, when you hear about Krishna's pastime, when you have the darshan, that is a real darshan. So, let's conclude that how Krishna exhibited Chaturbhuja form to Pandavas and other devotees in that scene, because actually Krishna felt that Draupadi has one view, Bhima has another view. And in order to handle that scenario, Krishna exhibited a form called Chaturbhuja. So we understand Krishna exhibits different forms at different circumstances suitable for the devotees' relationship and the bhakti rasa which they enjoy. So, with this understanding, we should know with present moment, as a sadhaka, as a aspiring devotees, the form which we can appreciate and relish is the form of a deity in the temple. So, we should come to temple, participate in the sankirtana movement, chant Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, and then connect ourselves with the form of the Lord in the temple as a archa form, and then make a progress to different stages. So we'll stop here. Srila Prabhupada ki.